this video, we will discuss benefits of the Cadm VPN and how to use it. First, we will briefly cover the organization of the college network, then the VPN's role in accessing the college's private resources, after which we will briefly discuss a few situations where using the VPN may or may not be helpful. Finally, we will cover, step by step, how to connect to the Cadm VPN. The college has many public-facing resources, such as public RGS Blade workstations, Citrix applications, the Cadm web server, VPN services, and much more. These resources can be accessed using any internet connection anywhere in the world. The college has a few private resources that are only available from an on-campus internet connection. The college VPN services provide a way to gain access to these private resources. When you connect to the VPN, your computer establishes an encrypted link over the internet to Cadm and provides access to the private portion of the Cadm network. Once this connection is established, it's as if your computer were on campus. When on campus, by either physically plugging in your computer to the BYU wired network or by using the BYU secure wireless network, you will have access to both the public-facing and private college resources. There is no need to use the VPN when using either an on-campus wired or BYU secure wireless connection. All the public and private resources are already available. Currently, using BYU Guest Wireless, you will not be able to access any of the public or private college resources. BYU Guest Wireless supports basic internet browsing only. BYU Guest Wireless does not currently support college VPN services. Using BYU Guest Wireless, you will not be able to access any of the private college resources with or without the VPN. Examples of when the VPN might be helpful are when you are off campus and you would like to access a research computer on campus in a lab where you work, or if you would like to map your J drive to your computer. In order to use the Cadm VPN, you must first configure your computer to connect to it. The following instructions on how this is done are based off Windows 7. First, click the Internet Access button in the system tray. Then, on the bottom of the box that pops up, click Open Network and Sharing Center. Then, click Set up a new connection or network from the list of options. Next, click Connect to a workplace, and then the Next button. Choose the Use My Internet Connection option and click the Next button. Enter the following information in the appropriate fields. Internet address should be fortress.et.byu.edu. Destination name should be Cadm. Mark the box, Don't Connect Now, just set it up so I can connect later. Then click the Next button. Then enter your Cadm username and password into the appropriate fields, but leave the domain field blank. Select Create. Your VPN connection has now been created, but further configuration is necessary. Again, click the Internet Access button in the system tray, right-click Cadm, and then click Properties. Click on the Security tab, then for Type of VPN, choose Point-to-Point Tunneling Protocol. Click on the Networking tab, highlight Internet Protocol version 4, and click Properties. Then click the Advanced button. Click on the DNS tab and click the Add button. In the DNS server field, type 128.187.48.2 and click Add. Next, click on the Winds tab and click Add. In the Winds server field, type 10.8.120.176. Repeat this step and type 10.8.120.177 to add a second Winds entry. Finally, click the OK and Close buttons until all the windows are closed. The configuration process is now complete. Before you connect to the VPN, make sure you are currently connected to the internet. To connect to the configured Cadm VPN, you can click the Internet Access button, click Cadm, and click the Connect button. Unless you save your credentials, you will be asked to re-enter your Cadm username and password each time you choose to connect. At this point, you should be connected to both the Cadm VPN and the internet at the same time. For more detailed information and other videos about our resources, visit info.et.byu.edu.